Hello there, all you amazing tech people out there. We're going to talk about swap files or page files. I actually was talking to someone at work and I called it a pig file. If you don't know what pegging is, I don't know what the fuck why I had that in my brain, but swap files, page files, cache files, it has different names. And if you Google it right here, it says like a swap file is a system file that creates temporary storage space on a solid state drive or a hard disk. Well, we should all be using solid state drives nowadays. When the system wants lower some memory. The file swaps a section of RAM storage from an idle program and frees up memory for other programs. This is kind of the logistics, the simple version of it. You see a lot of, especially Linux people say, oh, we need a swap file or swap partition. And to be clear, let's debunk this right away. The Linux kernel uses a swap file as fast as it uses a swap partition. We are talking nanoseconds differences here. If you go and read the documentation from the kernel, the Linux kernel, it says that it sees no difference basically between a swap file and a swap partition in performances. So for all of those people, I've seen too many people being yelling and screaming at other people for using swap files versus partitions. Linux don't give a fuck. It really don't. Do you need page files, cache files, swap files, partitions and stuff like that? Yes and no. Most people, 99% of use cases, no. If you have enough RAM in your system to handle what you need to be handled, you don't need a swap partition file, whatever. A swap space. Let's just call it a swap space. It's really only useful when your RAM modules, like the physical RAM you have on your system, is not handling the task. And you may say, well, you idiot, I have 30, 60 gigabytes of RAM and my programs are still using my swap file. Some programs, they will, if they see a swap space, say, it makes sense because this is not missing critical and blah, blah, blah. It makes sense for us to put it in there because it don't, like, a swap space don't run as fast as physical RAM. So they're like, we'd rather have that RAM be accessible to the OS and blah, 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 and stuff like that. And some of it is just done by design because it's legacy design from the olden days of how they did it. If you took that, you know, swap space, page space away, the program would still be running. Just because the system uses it, it don't mean that you need it. Look at swap space, page space, cache files a little bit as RAM. That's what you have on your desk. I need to access my phone really, really, really often, so I lay it on my desk. That's the RAM. A swap space and partition, it could be something I have in the cabinets behind me. I may need it, but I don't need it as fast or as frequently. But I still need it to be accessible to me. RAM and swaps, like I said, they are... I don't know if I said that, but I think I did. I'm getting confused now because I was thinking about an analogy about where to put just my phone. But swap spaces and page files, they are massively slower than your physical RAM. So most modern systems, most modern programming prefer to use it. But they also recognize that, okay, we have this massive fucking swap space available. Why not use it? I know this sounds confusing, but programs will still run even if you don't have a page file or swap file or cache file or what you will call it. They will still run. If you're a crazy person that are just using your computer for consumption, you know, YouTube, Netflix and stuff like that, and you have 64 gigs of RAM in your system or 34, 32 or whatever, like 128, I don't know what the fucking numbers are anymore. Having a swap anything on any OS is basically useless. Where it can go in and be maybe needed is if you're running a lot of VMs, if you're video editing, because video editing software love physical RAM. They eat up as much physical RAM as they can do. So it makes sense to have like a swap file, a page file, that your system, that your OS can then be, okay, my physical RAM is getting really bogged up, used up by my video editor, blah, blah, blah. So I'm starting to unload some stuff into the page file, or swap file, or whatever you call it, until the idiot is done video editing, and then we will put it back in again. And then it makes sense. Then it makes perfectly sense. The notion of everyone needs swap, or page file, or cache file, it's so outdated. Like, it stems from the 90s, okay? It's something like, on Windows, it comes from the 90s, and Linux, we kind of used it up to like 2004-05-ish. And I know, if you go on to macOS, it automatically gives you a page file. I think that's what they call it there. And on Windows, it automatically also gives you, I can't remember what Windows is calling. I think it's also a page, or is it a cache file? I can't remember what I think Windows, let's just pretend Windows is also calling it a page file. Linux is using swap file or partition. Most distributions are either want you to create a swap partition by default, or want you to do it or automatically create a swap file. Think Ubuntu automatically creates swap files. That is a just-in-case situation. They don't really, the installer don't really look at the RAM and say, oh, this rule have way too much money and giving me, you know, have 64 gigabytes of RAM in their system, so I don't need a swap file. The installer don't look at it like that. It should it? Yeah, we could debate that till the cows comes home. But they just do basically have like a, what is the best practices for all system specs? So they rather give you a page file or a swap file when you install it by default than having to be like, okay, if you're installing this system on a 2 gig of RAM, or if you're installing this OS on a 2 gig of RAM system, make a swap file. It just be like, just for the sake of simplicity and stuff, that they just automatically give you a swap file. And when I went from 4 gig to 8 gig on Windows, it used less page file. When I went from 8 to 16, it used even less page file, and now I have 30 something. Actually, I can see that over here. How much RAM do I have? 32 gigs, and it's called page. It's using about, in the page pool, it's using 703 megabytes of stuff. And non-page pool is 355. Then there's cached and committed and compressed. And if you don't know what all of these means, don't get hooked up on them. I can go into Windows. I did that back in Windows 95, Windows 98 and stuff like that, because Windows ran like shit. So a lot of us, we went into the page file under Windows and we doubled the size of it. And the system starts to run amazingly good because we didn't have enough physical RAM. Nowadays, I think it's dynamic on Windows. The page file is dynamic. But theoretically, you could go in and remove it, should you? Nah. On Windows, leave it be. On macOS, leave it be. If Ubuntu gives you a swap file, just leave it be. But don't think that you need it. Most people don't need a swap file. You definitely don't need a swap partition. If anything, I don't care if you want swap space, but please don't fucking use a partition. The only situation I could see it being necessary to have swap, and where it's a must, is big server farms. Massively server farms. Where they're doing VM deployments, or storage deployments and stuff like, you know, just think storage servers, web servers, VM servers and stuff like that. I would probably have like a SSD with like a couple of terabytes on it just for swap. But that's not your computer. It's a desktop. You know, you're running desktop applications on it. You are doing desktop stuff. And for you, a swap file, a page file is way good enough. You don't need anything else. And if you're having, I would say in today's age, if you're having 16 plus gigabytes of RAM in your system and you're not video editing, you don't even need swap files or partitions anyway. But most people, they don't need a swap file or swap partition, but it could be nice to have. I hope this makes sense. See you all later. Bye bye.